Hello, everyone. Are you ready to amplify your videos with a smooth blur transition in CapCut? Well, you're in the right place. Welcome to our tutorial on how to make a smooth blur transition in CapCut step by step. This feature adds a cinematic and professional touch to your projects. Let's get started. First, open your CapCut. Here I already placed the sample video clip and music that we are using for today's video. When you already have your video and music, the first thing you need to do is to add some beat to the music. To do that, click on the music audio, and you will find the flag icon in the upper part of your video. The flag with an AI is used to generate a beat on your audio automatically, and the other one means you are going to add beats to your audio manually by pressing Ctrl plus J. This is how it's done. You play the audio using the space bar. Then while the audio is playing, you can press the Ctrl plus J to hit the beat you want in the music, and at the same time, you can add how many beats and control it by yourself. Do you see the yellow circle in the audio? That is the beat mark. Now, after adding beat marks in your audio, you need to split the clip, or if it is already split, you need to align it inside the beat mark. You can also adjust the audio to make them aligned, like what I did here. Next, if you're already aligned the beat and the video clip, you can now add a blank image. Just go to Media, then click Library, then add the white blank image. Then align the white image above the video clip and make sure that they are equal. Then change the opacity of the white image to 65%. Next, go to Animation, then click Out, then select Fade Out. After that, you can copy and paste the white image so all of the video clip has their own white image above. Make sure to align them all equally. It will be like this when you play it. Next, go to Effects. Then find and select Oblique Blur. Then set the blur and rotate to 100. After that, make it small, like around 1/4 of the size of one video clip. Next, copy and paste it to all of the video clips. And that's it. All you need to do is to cut the sound if you need to, and add some outro to it if you like. And this is the result. We hope you found this video tutorial helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.